Get ready to match the stars from Chips, Robert Pine, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Jamie Lee Curtis, Dick Martin, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rivers.
Hello there.
How are you? Good. Very lively audience. And a very lively bunch. What are you doing up there?
What? I'm sorry.
Well, you don't know how to tie a bow tie?
Sydney rushed me so that I didn't have time to get my bow tie tied right, so it was longer. And so Robert kindly, thank you, sweetheart.
If you dress in your own dressing room, it would be different.
I didn't hear that.
Oh, dear. Here we have Jeff Gamble and Georgia Lamb.
Hello.
Hello there. Now let's reacquaint ourselves with you two. Georgia, you have three children in the audience, right?
Yes, I do.
And you live in?
I live in Granada Hills.
Granada Hills.
I'm originally from Texas. I've been in California.
And you train salespeople.
Yes, I'm a sales manager. I have an inside sales department, and then I also go outside and travel.
That's what I hear.
That's right.
You go inside and outside.
Yeah. That's my children have been spreading the word.
Jeff?
Was that bad? Yes.
You're from Pasadena.
Wrong.
Oh, no, sorry.
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles, okay. And what do you do for a living? You're a bartender.
Bartender,
right.
For now.
Yeah. I knew he looked familiar.
No. All right, we're in the middle of round one here in the second game, right? And whose is this?
Mine.
Yours, okay.
Don't you think it's a little depressing when the contestant has to tell the MC who goes first?
That's how it starts.
I mean...
I quit. I'm getting out of here. I don't have to take this kind of
abuse. What is it?
Take over, Jamie. Take over, Jamie.
What?
Oh, sweetheart. Oh, right.
Go ahead, do it.
The Hollywood producer said... There's something wrong in this casting in this movie. It's the life story of Billy Carter. And in the starring role, they've got...
Blank.
Beep.
I thought you beeped.
No, blank. No, you did okay, Jamie.
Put it in anyway.
Okay. That's right. Okay.
Wrong.
Yes, that's wrong, but don't
Jeff, we're going to start
right now. Heavens.
The Hollywood producer said... He's finished. Hollywood producer said... Charles is finished, is that what he said? There's something wrong with the casting in this movie. It's the life story of Billy Carter, and in the starring role, they've got...
Pat Boone.
Pat Boone is a good answer. Now, Pat Boone, I think, is an excellent response. You know, because he's very square, he wears white shoes and all that stuff, and he's a goody-goody fellow.
And he drinks milk.
And he doesn't drink.
Peanuts.
And he hates peanuts and all that.
He's always spoken very well of you.
Oh, I love him. Oh, these are not negative things. These are all positive things I'm saying. You'll never see him on... never see him on this show, will you?
No, never.
Okay.
I was trying to think of the great teetotaler of the...
That would be a good approach.
That would be a good approach, except I think it's wrong. Amy Semple McPherson.
Amy Semple McPherson.
He was trying to think of the woman who originated the temperance.
Carrie Nation. Yeah, she was the one who started the Volstead Act and got it through.
Right.
She used to go with the mafia. Break about the saloons, that's
Wonderful.
Right.
Yeah. Sure.
Okay.
That woman should have been tarred and feathered. Imagine wanting people to stop drinking is shocking.
Yes.
No, I thought this was not brilliant, but not bad. I said Billy Graham. I think that's
Billy Graham.
Billy Carter.
In the mold of Pat Boone there.
Sylvester Stallone.
That would be incongruous. Incongruity is the...
I think this is incongruous.
You have another incongruous one, Jamie? Okay.
Richard Pryor.
Richard Pryor.
That's that, Jamie.
That is incongruous.
He's not going to cast any movies of mine.
Okay. Oral Roberts.
Oral Roberts, another winner there. Yes. Yes, sirree. Show us another winner, Betty.
And you know how well the Carters do in Congress.
Yes.
No, listen, I think I misunderstood the question, because as Dick Martin pointed out, this would be good casting. Brett Summers.
Yes, it would indeed. All right. So now we go to round two. The score is tied, zip to zip. Let's see. Jeff, you go first this time because she went first that time.
Okay, I'll take B again.
B again. All right. Weird Willie said,
yes.
He said, since I moved from New York, I've realized that I miss Central Park. And that's why I have blank in my living room. Ready? Weird Willie said, since I moved from New York, I've realized that I missed it. I miss Central Park, and that's why I have blank in my living room.
A mugger?
A mugger. They like it. Now, it's not true. We don't want to keep putting down New York all the time and saying they're muggers and all of those things. They've got a few problems there, but we're just kidding, New York. We love you. Hello there.
See, I don't think that's funny.
What?
I wouldn't say mugger. I said a rowboat.
A rowboat. Now, you've never been to New York. One of the traditional things tourists do in New York is take a rowboat ride in the lake in Central Park.
It's one of those little mechanical men that comes up and hits you over the head and takes your wallet.
Okay.
You can't do that anymore because it's all mud. No, no. God love you, sweetheart. I loved your Patch Boone answer. Do you like me accent? I set four muggers on sleeping bags.
Oh. Okay.
What's upset you?
What's wrong?
Well, I was born in New York, Gene, and these questions.
They hurt you. They cut you to the quick, don't they?
On the concourse in the Royal Hospital.
Yes.
And I agree with Robert, whose answer rowboats was such a lovely one.
It's wonderful.
Yeah. You're dying!
And throw me the Kleenex there.
Yeah. I would just like to keep it coming.
Yes, yes, of course. Yeah.
I agree with him.
Yes.
And I chose for my answer something so lovely. Those filthy, dirty, smelly pigeons.
Twice in one show, you've come up with the definitive answer. Pigeons. Pigeons is what he kept in there, Jamie. You've been in New York?
Not a lot. I don't like
really?
New York.
Don't say you don't like New York.
I thought of Betty White when I said this. I really thought we'd be on the same brainwave.
What do you say?
Dog
doo-doo.
Only because you love dogs.
Right, go.
I'm afraid I'm with Charles's great performance, Pigeon Dropping.
Pigeon Dropping is in my living room. That'd be a great song title.
Silly.
Pigeon Droppings in My Living Room.
Oh. Well, I just... Jamie's new here, so you have to forgive an answer like that from her. You know, I said Doggy Refuse.
Doggy Refuse. Yeah.
He's the one who wrote it.
Well, okay, where are we here? Middle of round two. It's one to nothing, and you're going to have one more shot at it. Right now, this for you. Now, Georgia,
yes.
Last chance.
I'll take it.
One to tie, two to win.
Let's do it.
Okay.
Now.
Here we
Bricklemeyer
go.
University.
I went there.
Hey,
you went there? It's a strange place, isn't it? Say it is a strange place.
It's a strange place.
Thank you. Instead of a sheepskin, the graduates get a sheep blank.
I got it.
Yes. Bricklemeyer University is the world's strangest college. Instead of a sheepskin, the graduates get a sheep blank.
Sheepskin.
Okay. You ready with an answer, Georgia?
Why can't I think what they get? I know, instead of sheepskin.
You're the head of your department.
Of course I am.
Yeah. And your job is secure. You're not depending on us for the money here, are you?
Until this hour. Instead of a sheepskin, the graduates get a sheep... Oh, my word.
You must say something before the buzzer
I
sounds.
I can understand. Instead of a sheepskin, the graduates get... I'm coming with an answer. Instead...
Of... What was it? Say it.
Wool.
Sheep wool?
No. Give me another minute.
No, you got it. She's cute. Have to take it first. Instead of a sheepskin, they get sheep wool. Okay.
Oh.
Listen, Jeff, you're not a too nifty a player either. You only got one. But it looks to me like you're going to win this game. That's what happens. You got two rotten players up there. What do you say there?
I got sheep.
Sheep dip. Hey. Okay. Let's see if we can.
Georgia, what part of Texas are you from, sweetheart?
A very small part.
Where is it?
Temple.
Where?
Temple.
She went to Brickell,
Maryland. Oh, I know where Temple. I know where Temple is.
Cattle country,
she doesn't
obviously
have a touch of accent, does she?
Well, she studied it. She studied English and lost her.
It's all right. I think you're cute. Anyway, I said sheep herder.
Sheepskin, you get a sheep herder.
That's a person who tends sheep. You get him to take home a sheep herder. That
okay
is a wonderful answer.
When
you
she moved
think about
last
that
week, she moved her manger from on top of the closet and two herders fell down on the floor. I got with me, Gene, a bag of this stuff here. It is sheep dip. And
sheep
anyone
dip
else wants it.
Right. Sheep dip is the definitive answer there. Because it's a funny sound, Jamie.
Dip.
Oh, you do? Yes, of course.
I dip.
You dip? Oh, yes, funny.
Dippity
three
doo
dips doo down here.
Right.
All right, that means Jeff wins the game. All right. Right now, little blue guy. Yeah, okay, I'll tell you.
Thanks a lot.
We're going to send some gifts your way.
Thank you.
Good luck to you. Georgia Land, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for her. Well. Gonna try it again, are you? How about if I just give you $10 and you leave? No, you got a chance to win a lot of money here in the Super Match. We polled another studio audience. Jeff said, write down your best answer to this. Blank rye. Remember, it's 500 for matching the most popular, 250 for the second most, and 100 for the third most popular. Remember now, study your stars here and see which one has a glimmer of an answer.
Jamie again.
Catcher in the
Rye.
Is that okay?
Very famous book.
Betty.
There are two kinds, but I'm going to say Swedish.
Swedish Rye.
A real winner, Betty.
And Charles.
I didn't need that, Brett.
Ham and cheese on rye!
And if she's on rye, catcher in the rye, and Swedish rye.
Now, don't let the acting, the applause I got for my acting, mislead you, because it could be a crummy answer, well acted.
It was. It was a crummy answer, badly acted.
True. Ham and cheese on rye. Yeah.
You want it anyway. Okay. Now, do you really agree with that? Yeah. About two-thirds of you do. We'll find out if we got a ham and cheese up there someplace. May we see the $100 number? No. Catcher in the rye is Jamie's answer.
Oh, at the bottom.
Right? Let's go up the ladder. Look at the next one, please. Coming through the. If a body, kiss a body.
He shouted through the rye. Swedish rye.
Through the Swedish rye, right. Okay, let's see if we got ham and cheese on Swedish rye. Go!
Yeah! Yeah.
$1,000. Jeff, you've won another $500. That means at this instant you have a total of $1,000. Now we're going to multiply the 500 by 10, gives you 5,000. And that's what you're playing for. But again, you're going to spin the star wheel, and good luck to you. I hope it ends up in a double. You'll play for $10,000. Here we go. $10,000. That's what he's playing for. He got a double with Charles N. Riley. Okay, good luck to you. Here it is. Right. Red as blank. There it is. Red as blank. R-E-D. A-S. Red as. Jeff, have you got an answer yet? He's just about ready.
Could he move it, Charles?
There we go. Okay.
Good
Jeff,
luck.
If you give us the answer that he's got on the card, you get $10,000. There it is.
As a rose.
Red as a rose. Now, that's a lovely thought. Red as a rose is a beautiful thought. Romantic.
We tried. I'm serious. All of us tried. When I said red as a beet. We had red as a
red as a beet.
Red as a rose.
What was yours?
Good.
Red as fire.
Red as fire? Red as
a beet. We had a big meeting, and no one got near a rose.
Jeff Campbell, you got a total of $1,000, and our best wishes. Congratulations to you. Now, we have this message for you.
If you'd like to come to the studio out here in Hollywood and see Match Game in person, we'd love to meet you. Write to us. Enclose a self-addressed stamp envelope mailed to tickets. Match Game at CBS Television City, 7800 Beverly Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90036.
Now, let's bring on two more players now. Here comes Tavy Lee and Kirstie Alley. And Kirstie. Now, welcome to both of you. As you know, you'll both be playing both games. Tavy.
Right.
Let's find out who you are and where you're from.
My name is Tavy Lee.
I said that.
Did you?
I said Tavy Lee.
Good.
And I pronounced it correctly, too.
Yeah, I owe a girl a dollar for that. I'm from Houston, Texas. I'm 67 years old. I've been married 47 years. I'm still in love.
You are? 47 years,
right.
And you're still...
And still in love.
With the same guy?
Yes, married all the time.
Yeah.
Glad.
Married all the time.
Glad to tell you about it.
Yes.
And I'm a homemaker. I spend a lot of time at home and playing bridge and visiting with my grandchildren, which today I have two in the audience with two daughters and one son and a daughter-in-law.
Your cup overfloweth.
Oh, and I'm a happy grandmother.
Good for you, Tavy. Nice to meet someone happy. Kirstie, is that what you say?
Kirstie.
As in thirsty, huh? Where do you live?
I live in Wichita, Kansas.
Specifically, what is your address and phone number? No, I'm only kidding. No, you can't say that. I'm only kidding. It's a little touch of humor. Kirstie, you live in Wichita, Kansas.
Right.
And what brings you here?
Work. I'm an interior designer, and I'm out here working.
Uh-huh. Well, I'm glad you found the time to come in and visit us here on Match Game.
Thank you.
Good luck to both of you ladies. I'll push this button and ask Tavy to choose A or B.
A.
A it is.
A this, for anniversary.
This program goes to Houston, among other places.
And
it's a wonderful big city.
That's three cities already.
That's right.
What a show.
No, we sent it to Houston, and they keep sending it back. Long John Silver said, I taught my dog to fetch. Today he brought back a pirate's blank. That's what Long John Silver said. I taught my dog to fetch.
Get off me, I want to drink my club soda. I'm so thirsty.
Okay, David. Long John Silver said, I taught my dog to fetch. Today he brought back a pirate's blank.
Wooden leg.
Very good, Tavy.
Wooden leg.
The lady from Houston said wooden leg.
Well, I'm picking up this game.
Wooden leg. Oh, yeah.
How long have we been doing this show?
Long time.
Boy, oh boy, I wish I could pick it up.
You didn't say wooden leg?
No, you read it in such a sexy voice, it kind of turned me on. I said girlfriend.
I taught my dog to fetch. Today brought back a pirate's girlfriend.
What's wrong with that, sweetheart?
Well, that's okay.
It's better than a wooden leg, isn't it?
The dog would have to have, as they say in hunting circles, a very small, a soft mouth in order to bring back an entire girlfriend. Hello.
Yeah?
Wooden leg is a good answer. Mine is the full, complete answer. Wooden leg, my hearties.
Wooden leg, my hearties. So pirate.
It's saltier that way.
Yo ho ho, and a bottle of milk.
Hello.
Hello. His girlfriend, who he fetched, has splinters in her leg from his wooden leg.
Aha!
Aha! Katie, now three.
Three for Katie.
The pirate is not going to have any fun with the with a wooden leg. I brought back his sister.
Aha!
There you go.
It's the same. We were on the
same
track.
Those islands get lonely.
They do.
Let her walk that plank.
That's right. You can do more with the sister than you can with the wooden leg. I'll tell you that.
So you say.
Oh, aha. Uh-huh. Okay.
Moving right along.
I didn't say wooden leg. I said a pirate's skull and crossbones.
Skull and crossbones. A dog would have a tendency to bring bones, something like that.
One
right.
to play with and one yes. to eat. Dog lover that she is.
You did very well for a first round question. You stand by for yours, please. Now we have this for you. I'm Gene Rayburn. And you, I don't know who you are. Join us the Wonder Minute Investigators. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are Glamour Top, the new do-it-yourself kitchen countertop is custom fitted, ready for you to install a replacement countertop in over 50 gorgeous colors and patterns. And Blue Luster Shampooer and Blue Luster Plus Carpet Shampoo with grease cutters and brightness to remove ground-in dirt and grime. And Potato Toppers, exciting flavor, color, and texture for baked, mashed, and boiled potatoes. Just sprinkle and serve in your grocer's produce section. Potato Toppers. And entertaining style with beautiful Dynaware paper plates from Fonda. Dynaware, the heavyweight paper plates with extra thickness, firmness, and strength. Dynaware. And a deep fryer and a supply of spoon and fry donut mix. Make delicious hot fresh donut holes in minutes. Just add water to Golden Dips new spoon and fry donut mix. Great family fun. And Playmobil, the little people that can go anywhere, do anything, and can be anyone your kids can imagine. That's Playmobil. And from Hawaiian Tropic comes an attractive beach mat and Hawaiian Tropic natural tanning lotions and oils. Hawaiian Tropic, the tan of the island. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Max Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.